3.2.
In the codfish, because we're in uncharted waters up here, only a few boats come up. We did manage to get some waypoints for this river, so yeah, we've been tagging across a completely different landscape to where we've been, but yeah, something different. Probably there's mangroves, so maybe the midges will come out. Yeah, so we're heading up in here. Again, the joy of an ovni. We've had some shallow waters, but we've managed to get past those. I think so far we've only seen 2.4 under the keel, so that's deeper than we were anticipating, which is great. But yeah, lovely and calm up here in the Drysdale River. Drysdale River, actually an offshoot of the Drysdale River, called Forest River. It was pretty intense to get up here. We came through unsurveyed waters, got to a depth of 1.5 at one stage. Anyway, we're up here. There's a place here called Barra Camp. We've seen lots of fish jumping, so Rob's getting excited about the fishing. And yeah, it's way at the head. And as you can see, there's this little island and we're spinning around here. Somewhere up here that we can go and anchor near, but just checking it all out at the moment. Again, pretty spectacular, different to the King George and the Berkeley, but yeah, pretty chuffed to have got up here. Not many people come up here at all. There's not much information.
Drysdale River, only about 500 metres from the rock bar at the top, and you can see we've got one stern line out over there because it's 30 metres deep here and a rocky bottom, so we certainly don't want to get our anchor stuck. So we have tied off to the shore. And just up here is the rock bar where we took the dinghy this afternoon, right up there. And there's our two bow lines. We probably only need one, but the angles weren't quite right, so we went for two. And hopefully we get a, well, we should get a very good night's sleep here. Probably very little wind. And we hope we're not disturbed by the 17-foot crocodile that was spotted here in 2018 by the guys doing croc surveys that we met this afternoon. We wonder how many they'll count tonight. We've seen one.
Here. How cool is this? spectacular. And we are right tied up to these rocks. And look where we are. It is another little piece of paradise in the Kimberleys. And we spin around here. Look up there, that sky.
Waverley. We're checking out the Bradshaw paintings, or Gwion Gwions. And there's a lot of art here. Some of it's fairly hard to see. Like, I didn't actually notice that little hand there. And yeah, this whole wall was covered at one stage. But they say it's up to, well, is it 20,000 or 15,000 years old? So a lot of it has been lost. But I do wonder if that one up there, that higher one, is from a different era. The
that one?
No, the one up to, further to the, yeah, that one up there. It just looks different, doesn't it?
It does look different. Different to the other quite intricate artwork that we're seeing here. And yeah, it's pretty amazing that after all those years, well, that's what they estimate roughly how old it is, that it is still here and what the art forms are.
They definitely knew good quality paint, didn't they, back then?
And can imagine this being a little oasis for them here.
Oh, what a view.
Yeah.
Spectacular view.
And
you can just see the mast of Galatea over there.
See if I zoom in. There's her mast. Another nice sunset, and yet again, dinghy is high and dry, but thankfully I think we can get it out.